God, always faithful in your love for us, we rejoice in your presence with us. You created love, you unite us in one human family, you offer your word and lead us in light, you open your loving arms and embrace us with strength. May the presence of Christ fill our hearts and make new, with new joy, the lives of your servants whose marriage we come here today to celebrate. Bless the love of Tim and Tori for each other. May the power of your Holy Spirit sustain them and all of us in a love that knows no end. Amen. Tim and Tori, inasmuch as you have expressed your desire to seal the love that you have found through the celebratory rite of Christian marriage, I challenge you to remember that the basis of human love is divine love. It may seem to you that being raised in this church, you have different memories and a different relationship to this church even than do I and many others here. You have your own relationship, you have your own history in the coming together at this moment. But I ask you to put that aside in a way because there's another road that I'm going to refer to now. I encourage you to seek together not only the promises of human love that you are about to make, but also that you come together to encourage the process of growing in divine love. Let your lives not be only committed to each other, but may you also be committed to God's love that looks so powerfully revealed in Jesus the Christ. As you mutually yield your hearts and bodies to each other in love, may you also grow in your relationship called you to growth and to health and to hope and to faithfulness. We know that any argument that they come our way, I'm sure they'll come again. We know that there's your way, there's the right way, and there's God's way. And sometimes when you know you're right, absolutely know you're right, but you're not getting past this impasse, I encourage you to say, what's God's will? We came together and got married. It was my will, and I said, yes, I want to marry this man. It was your will, yes, I want to marry this man. And there was God saying, I was present at your wedding. You invoked my presence. And I want you to invoke my presence again throughout your marriage. And if the solemn vows you are about to make are kept, and if you endeavor to do the will of God, your life will be full of joy, and the home you establish, in it you will abide. No other human ties are more tender. No other human vows are more sacred than the one you are about to assume. Before God in this congregation, I ask you both to affirm your willingness to enter into this covenant of marriage and to all the joys and sorrows of this relationship, whatever the future may hold. Yeah. Will you have Tori to be your wedded wife? Will you love her as faithfully as long as you both shall live, if so say I will, with the help of God. Tori, will you have Tim to be your husband, and will you love him faithfully as long as you both shall live, if so say I will, with the help of God. And will the family and friends of Tori and Tim answer in support of this couple? Do you offer your prayerful blessing and loving support to this marriage? If this was 2,000 years ago in Israel, if something were to happen to one person in the marriage, they were to have kids or whatever, the only persons who were really able, you wouldn't go to the Social Security Administration. You would go to those who were present. When the power of God and Christ were invoked at the wedding, and you say, yes, I showed up at the wedding, I spoke up in vows of support. Now that something has happened, of course you can turn to us. So I ask you with solemnity and also celebration, will the family and friends of Tori and Tim answer in support of this couple? Do you offer your prayerful blessing and loving support of this marriage? If so, say, we do.
We do.
Assist them with your grace that with true fidelity and steadfast Thank you.